I'm tired. I got dressed for the beach. And I am just laying here on the bed because I'm tired. I am tired. And what I want to say to you is, if you're tired too, rest. We deserve rest. I don't know how it's been going for you, but this year, it's June. It's the middle of June. And this year has not taken its foot off my neck. I don't know about you, but this year has not taken its foot off my neck. It has been one thing after the other after the other. And I feel like I am being forced to not only be still, but to take full stock of why I believe what I believe, why I feel the way I feel, and truly get in touch with my feelings about everything and my emotions and how it impacts my physical health, my mental health. I cannot get into details about everything that has happened over the past 6 months because I am still processing. You know, there's been a death in my family. My grandmother passed away. I mean, and then there's been other trauma after that. But this might be helpful to some of you, but I just feel like right now it's really important. The bus. I feel like right now it is supremely important that we maybe just in one area of our lives that this will keep popping up, but I think this is a period in time where we are going to be forced to unearth deep emotions and really get in touch with those emotions. And one thing that I learned recently is that I intellectualize my feelings. So what that means is, instead of actually feeling my feelings, I can't describe to you what the emotion feels like in my body because I've totally disconnected from that when it comes to certain situations. And I didn't realize this, like, I can talk about my feelings or what's going on or, you know, my perception of this thing that is happening to me, but when it comes to specific situations or specific areas of my life, I cannot access those feelings because I've repressed them so much. And it's been really challenging dealing, not only dealing with those emotions as they come up, but also sitting with them and just being honest with myself about what I've done. And I don't mean what I've done in terms of like to cause this stuff, but what I've done in terms of repress them so much that I am disconnected from myself. There's a level of dishonesty there with that disconnect, right? Because you can't fully be honest with yourself, you can't fully be honest with other people about how you feel and what you feel if you aren't like aware of it, if you aren't completely tuned into that. So it has been challenging for me, and I guess what I will share with you guys, if you are experiencing the same thing, to help you through, be patient and be gentle with yourself. And try to extend the same level of care and compassion that you would to a friend, to a loved one, to a relative. Try to extend that to yourself. Some of what I have been dealing with has been like, I'm literally exhausted physically on every plane, and I have had to surrender because I cannot control everything that's happening around me. I can only control myself and how I react to what is happening. Do I always get it right? Sure don't. Am I always coping in a healthy way? Definitely not. am I trying to? Am I trying to get better? Am I actively working on getting better at coping in healthier ways? And, you know, doing what I need to do to be a better human being, a more wholesome, healthy human being on all levels, all planes. Yeah, I'm trying. Not always successful, but I'm trying. So I encourage you guys to keep trying. It's hard when you feel like you've been doing the work for a long time and you feel that you should be at a certain point, and then something comes and all this stuff that you think you've worked through before, actually you haven't, and now it's coming up, like actually coming up. Not the echo of it, not the ghost of it, not the essence of it, the actual emotion, the actual feeling, actually, the life is something related to, you know, your childhood, like you find yourself regressing a little bit or being triggered to go back to that emotional state, maybe where you were as a child experiencing certain trauma, all of that, it's happening. It has been happening to me. And so if you are dealing with that same energy around this time, I am just encouraging you to keep working at it and working on yourself. I'm certainly having to tell myself that every like, there are days where I'm just like, fuck it. I ain't doing shit today. I ain't. And when I say I'm not doing shit, I don't mean like physically. I mean, I can't. It gets exhausting. It gets tiring. It takes a lot out of you. But what I'm realizing is that I have to value myself enough to do the work on myself that I need to get me to where I need to be. Even if that just means that I am a better person because of it. You know, there might not be anything tangible at the end. It doesn't mean that, you know, after I fix myself, I find someone that loves the fixed version of me or anything like that. Like, I'm literally just, I'm doing this because I deserve it. I deserve to be healed. I deserve to be in a place where my past doesn't have power over my future or my now. So I want to encourage you guys to just keep pushing. It's hard. I know it's hard, but we can figure it out. So that's all I got to say today, guys. Until next time.